Every proteomics experiment needs two pieces of data to get started with identification of peptides and then identification of proteins. The first piece of data is the spectra. So the .raw file that we get from our instrumentation is going to tell us when particular M over Z ratios were detected during the experiment. But we don't yet have the ability to look at those spikes, look at the different peaks that we get from a mass spec experiment and determine what types of proteins are in the sample. Instead, what we're able to do is give the computer, give the software that's going to identify the spectra, give it a database of possible proteins that then can be on the computer simulated to be broken up into different peptides. And then the spectra that we might see can be generated. So we can compare a database and a library of spectra that we expect to see to our experimental spectra. And that's the basic process that we're going to do on Galaxy after this assignment. So we want to put together a list of all those proteins. Most of them are going to be already put together for us in the human proteome from uniprot.org. So if we go to UniProt, we can look up proteomes. One of the proteomes that is first on the list because it's commonly downloaded is the Homo sapien proteome. And we can download this file. So you see gene count 20,591. We can click on it and download the file. It will come down as a zipped file. So we'll need to unzip it to be able to use it on the computer. The second thing that we might expect to see in a proteomics experiment are common lab contaminants. And so this database is referred to as the CREP database, or at least that's what they say it should be pronounced as. And we are going to copy two common non-human protein contaminants. So pig trypsin and cow albumin are really common proteins that you'd see just because they're gonna be used in the lab during the experiment. And so we wanna make sure that we eliminate both of those, or that we have both of those in our database. So if those contaminants are in the sample, they map to the right location. So we can look up the names of those proteins on UniProt. I'm gonna show you how to do this for bovine albumin. And I was looking in the wrong part of the database. And we can download the FASTA file. So we have this FASTA file right here. We have our zipped folder. So we can unzip it, extract to a new folder, and open up the FASTA file. And then we can open it up in any text editor. So you can download a text editor that you would use for writing code, something like Sublime or Notepad++. Or you can just open this up with tools that are already on your computer. So for PC, that would be Notepad. For Mac, it would be TextEdit. I'm just gonna open this up on Notepad. I can see it's a very large file, and I can scroll all the way to the bottom to add my non-human sequence. So I'm just gonna hit return, go to the web browser, copy the sequence, and paste it in. Now that I've modified this, I want to change the name of it. So I'm going to save it to my desktop and I'm going to call it the name of the proteome _ bovine albumin and then today's date. So now we'll know this isn't just the human proteome, this UP number that represents all of the proteins in humans, it also contains bovine albumin. Once I have my file updated with both proteins, so you'll wanna also add porcine trypsin, then it's ready to upload to Canvas.